Mara's grave. I keep forgetting it's so close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Oh. I was done for. Holy shit, you know? Thank you so much. Oh, man.
Name's Deacon. They know who I am. Stay off the main...
I never knew that.
Rest in peace. They can't get you now.
Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Maybe in one of these. Got it.
Nice.
supposed to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they are. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Okay.
What did you drop?
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Getting hungry?
Field note 000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance, and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
King O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Sling up the babies, sir.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping.
Bushes.
They're hibernating.
I gotta get to the bushes.
Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See the caves? Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
What the hell are we doing out here, anyway?
What you told?
Did you see something?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't...
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
What do we got? Still got this. Okay, let's take a look around. Let's see. What's going on here? Back on track.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. As one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds. Things didn't feel so great for them. The cemeteries were filled with others. Those who sought to all the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last week before the feds fell.
Broadcast from town to town. Why aren't you moving,
days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with... I'll just take these.
Now,